Turns out even fake war is exhausting.
Hey, I'm Brett. Some people call me the Amtrekker. Really, I'm just a guy with a list. I left my home, I left my job, and now I'm traveling the country with nothing but a backpack full of technology and a whole lot of faith in the kindness of strangers. I don't spend any money on lodging, which makes for some interesting nights, and I'm not going home until everything is crossed off the list. Call me a nomad, call me a vagrant, or call me Amtrekker.
My dearest Millie, the reenactment continues to rage on. The Battle of Newmarket is upon us, and the Virginians seem to be a particularly resolute peoples. Confederate gray can be seen drilling no more than 50 yards from our camps. Morale has been taxed to its limits, as the time between drilling is the only available for rest. Night brings with it the powerful cold of May, and I'm afraid that without your warm heart and gentle touch, the standard issue blanket does not fare well at keeping me adequately warmed for a peaceful night's sleep. I find that rations are few and far between, but the hardy civilians who populate the outskirts of the battlefield occasionally provide what I've come to call grand feasts. Oftentimes a slice of bread and a piece of meat. Or they spit down the barrels of our muskets. Marching and drills take our minds off the hunger and exhaustion, but they do not relieve me of my thoughts of home. After we meet our brothers in arms on the battlefield tomorrow, there will be a scant 16 objectives between myself and your sweet embrace. Today brought with it a tactical mission calling for us to march through a heavily wooded valley in an effort to flank the rebels. To our eternal mortification, the Confederate soldiers failed to fall at our initial volley. Instead, we found ourselves under hoof of the cavalry and were forced to flee. A short time later, musket fire brought with it the sweet and gentle nap time of fake death. I've enclosed photographs taken from the battlefield whilst I lay beyond the fake veil. I anticipate a similar campaign tomorrow, as we are honor bound to retreat beyond our own cannons and watch as the enemy takes them. Instead, dearest Millie, I may just choose to fall dead once more, in a location convenient to my backpack in the parking lot, of course. From my newly heightened perspective, I see that reenacting is best left to tougher men than I. For now, I will simply trudge forward on my quest to make it back to your sleek frame and sturdy box springs. Send word to my family that I have survived yet another life-affirming task. Loyally yours, Private Amtrekker.
What? I could name my laptop Charlie, but I can't name my bed Millie? It happens. Normal people do that. No big deal. So here's this week's email. It's from Pete, and he's in Crystal, Minnesota. He says, "Great work. Very inspiring. What do you like to do to pass the time when you're traveling alone? Thanks, and keep it up." So thanks for that email, Pete. And the sad irony here is that I don't have a lot of free time to pass. You'd think that traveling around being homeless and unemployed, I'd be trying to fill all this time, but I am almost always either adventuring or writing about my adventures or editing video from my adventures. So 99.9% of my time is spent Amtrekkering. But besides that, I do keep a book with me all the time, and as soon as I finish it, I just pass it off to whoever happens to be around that has a book to trade. And I still keep up on TV shows, Lost and The Office, both awesome, and God bless the internet for that. And that's about it. Really, not a lot of free time. But thanks so much for that email. And if you'd like to send one over to the podcast, that's www.h@amtrekker.com. 5 W's and an H. And if you're one of the friends over at myspace.com/amtrekker, you get a bulletin every time something new goes up on the site, which is normally very often. This week, less often. But next week, all kinds of fun adventure to be had. And let's see, you can follow me on Twitter now and get like up-to-the-minute updates. If I get arrested or seriously maimed, you'll be the first to know if you're over at twitter.com/amtrekker. And besides that, head over to www.amtrekker.com. That's where all the blogs are that fill in the holes, and that's where the podcasts are, in theory, every Wednesday. Although sadly, today is Saturday, and the new podcast still isn't up. So, I'll see you guys next week, though, when the new podcast will be up in time, and it'll be all about me river kayaking. See you guys then.
Guys need any ice?